Hello, everybody, and welcome back to the Pokemon Ultra Sun Blind Nuzlocke. Now, you may see me in different clothing and think, hey, wait, did I miss an episode? No, you did not. In between last episode and this one, I decided to walk down that road of Hauli City down to the Pokemon Center. And in between that route was the clothing shop, so I stopped at the clothing shop and got clothes. You also missed some generic cutscenes with Lily, which are in the first Sun and Moon, so there's nothing new. Something that was new, though, was Ilima was right here, and he was like, hey, I'm putting up these stickers called totem stickers. Look for them. So I peeled it off, I got one, and then there was another one over by the clothing store. And that's it. Also, everyone is 14. Because do you think I'm kidding around anymore? No. I already lost this Nuzlocke once. I don't want to lose it again. Especially this early on. So, I don't know what we're up against, but I'm going to go into the assumption that I'm going to fight Ilima again. I don't know what he's going to have, but if it's anything like his Smeargle, it's going to be tough. So, I have to go in with the assumption of it'll be difficult, so I got to be prepared. How's that? You got good eats, got to find him, or you found him, I guess. It's how with his Malasadas, as usual. They more, you make you more affectionate, okay. Yo, oh my god, Team Skull's here! That's a small change. So either Ilima's not going to be involved. You, he want to throw us a bone and handle those Island Challenge amulets to us now? Oh, so you're part of Team Skull, huh? Like, I guess everyone would steal totem stickers and... You steal totem stickers. Well, maybe if Ilima didn't just put them everywhere in plain sight... Never mind. In the way of those Island Challenges. You know it! We hate the Island Challenge, yo! And every kid fooling him to try it! Yo, let's check these fools! Let's see, sounds cool. Also, another way of challenge. Okay. I already liked this game less than the other one. For the first time, I'm dead serious. It's got plenty of time to change your mind, but I missed the opening with Ilima and how he just pays them no mind. Like, he completely ignores them. And, like, barely acknowledges that they were there and stuff. I love that. That's my favorite part of Team Skull. That they're just a bunch of stupid idiots and no one takes them seriously. But they took that aspect out for this first meeting, so. But yeah, so it's basically a game breaker is what I'm saying. It's a complete game breaker, and I had animations off when I was training, and I forgot to turn back on. Shocker, who saw that coming? But whatever. I may be overpowered for a certain couple battles, but that first Zubat was at little frickin' 9. Before I was playing a different game! I was playing the first Sun and Moon! Come on, this poor B, nobody has to know about this. Put on your little acclimatality. We wouldn't even take it if you gave them to us. Even though you asked for them. Those Team Skull Jerks really must have too much time on their hands, yeah? Yeah, those guys have no lives. You know, those people's doing Island Challenge isn't gonna make it like they managed to finish their... Isn't gonna just make it like they managed to finish theirs, you know? Okay, I guess they're trying to make it more... Team Skull is not... They're not just random thugs like they were before. Random pointless thugs, for that matter. Now they're specifically, like, just a gang who hates the Island Challenge and try to interfere with people's challenges. That, I guess, makes sense, and I'm okay with that. Do I fight Ilima now? Turn to school, can we butt? Yep. 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 I was right! What a shock! We're fighting Ilima! What a big freaking shock! The only difference is we didn't walk all the way down to the marina, and the dialogue was a little different. Okay, that's fine. Whatever. Whatever you guys want to do, Game Freak. Whatever you want to do. Young Goose, okay, that's the same. Go Shank! Also, this may be something someone have already said in the comment, but I haven't uploaded any episode yet. Shank is not technically a sword, and I didn't turn Battleation back on because it didn't let me go back to the menu. It didn't let me, because I was just in a conversation the whole time. Whatever, you guys can deal with it. Shank is not technically a sword. It is a blade, though, made of something not meant to be a weapon. Like a broken shard of glass, or... Like, something broken and then made into a weapon. Something makeshift, essentially. So, technically not a sword, but I don't really care, because I thought it made a lot of sense for... For fruit, and I'm gonna obliterate you, Ilima. Oh my god. Maybe I'm a little overleveled right now, but I actually couldn't care less. Sorry. I don't want to lose this Nuzlocke, and I didn't think 14 was too high. It's only one level higher than my team was already. I was already 13. So, bid you Alola. Okay, now I will turn Battle Nations back on. Okay, cool. I feel like I was saying something, but I forgot what it was. Probably complaining about the game, you know, the usual. This is new. Grrrr! I said, Alola Photo Club coming soon. Oh! I feel like this area was either under construction in the last one, or am I thinking of this plot of land here? No. I swear, this was either under construction in the last game, or it just was a house you couldn't go in. So, I'm pretty sure they added something there. A photo center. I wonder what that is. Is it something with the... another reason... I don't know how it is. It's pretty peaceful here. Yeah. Even though Team Skull just walked by a minute ago. Hey, here's my advice, trainer. If you're gonna send a tough boy, you're gonna use items in your Pokemon. You suck. Alright, is there any reason to even go to the marina? Because they didn't tell me to. We just went this direction and we fought Team Skull a bit earlier than before. There's an item down here. And what is that? A wizard hat? Oh no, it's a sticker hiding behind a blue construction cone. Yeah, I got 3 totem stickers now. Yay. I don't know what those do for me. All I know is that I'm supposed to be looking for them. Kinda like the Zygarde shards cells. More collectibles just all around the region. And there's 2 of them in just one little section of this game. So that means they ran out of spaces to hide them at this point, or there's a crap ton of them. Alright, I'm gonna hope to get it. There's a TM in there. I think I missed that in the first playthrough. We're not gonna miss it this time because I saw it. Ha ha ha. Okay, cool. Didn't run into anything. It is Echoed Voice. Alright, that's probably not gonna be too helpful. Can anyone even learn it? And what is even... It isn't even helpful for anything. 40 base power normal move. Special normal move. No thanks. I'd give it to Shank if he really needed to have a special move for some reason, but I don't think he will, because he's much better at physical attack, and he's got Headbutt, which is stronger, so... I apologize again for me being sick and sounding gross, but... Hey, there's a sticker. I see a sticker. I see it. Look. Look, I see it. There's a ton of these. I hope these actually do something for me. And they're not just, if you get them all, they're like, yeah, you did it! Here's a trophy to put in your non-existent secret base or something. I don't know. Are there any that are going to be in houses? Because... I saw that sticker here. That's a little silly. There's a sticker in that pool. Are you kidding me? I have to come back. Oh, with a fishing rod. Alright, remind me to come back here later, guys, after I get a fishing rod. Which should be after Lena's trial. I don't know if she'll have... I don't know if it'll be a wishy-washy again. Or if it'll be something else. Or if it'll leave me water. Or if Lena will leave me in the same place. I don't know that. Wait for me, Alchemy 11. Why would I wait for you, Lily? You don't do anything. I mean, you have a bit of character development later, but that's it. Anyways, I lost so quickly. I can't figure out the roads here. I can't even buy my own clothes. Wow. Wow. Okay, gain the strength to elegance the garden like Top of Coco. They love Pokemon battles. Yeah, that was the whole point of that festival. Remember that? I pay attention. You don't, obviously. I don't pay attention. Revives. Thanks for the revives, Lily. Thanks a lot. I hope it goes well for you. Well, thanks. I appreciate it. I appreciate it. Thank you. More! Yeah, give him a pat again. What were the other options? Touch its forelegs. Grab by the horns. Moo! Oh, that was actually a good thing? I thought that would be like a way to wrestle it. But alright, I guess it liked it. Maybe it's supposed to be like it's charging and I stop it? I feel like they should have actually animated it doing that! Finally, round frickin' 2! Alright, I don't want to get whatever's in that, Shaking Grass, because that was guaranteed to be a Makuhita last time I played. I don't want a guaranteed Makuhita. I want a... Alolan Rattata. I am so catching that. Level 7. Tackle might actually kill it. I'm not healed. We're actually going to go to Shamshir. And I'm going to use Bite, which is not very effective on it. Because I do not want to accidentally kill this thing. And I'm going to have to do Switch Trending for this thing, because no experience share. So that'll be a little annoying, but that's alright. Well, that's assuming I actually catch it. You flinched. I'm going to throw a ball now. You're a Rattata. You shouldn't be too hard to catch, in theory. Let's throw you in. Let's get you in a girly pink Pokeball. The dark, edgy rat in the pretty pink Pokeball. Gotcha. Planet Knight. Look, guys. I'm catching Pokemon. At night. I'm getting the experience. At night. I'm not sorry. So, Rattata, we need a nickname for Rattata. What's a good sword that rats use? Do rats use swords? You know what? This is gonna sound so stupid, but yes. It made me think of Mickey Mouse and the Three Musketeers. They use rapiers. At least I think they do. If they don't, they do now. They use some pointed curved sword. Pointed curved sword, isn't that an oxymoron? You know, it's a rapier! Okay? Let me heal, I'll be right back. We're back, hello! I wanna battle you. Welcome, trial goer! Yeah, she said some things. Also, this battle theme, I did say I didn't like it as much as the previous battle theme, but I still like it. And it's still true, but it's growing on me. I enjoy it. It's a good theme. But yeah, okay. Cutie Fly. Cannot stay in for that. We have a team of all males. Team Sausage Fest 2.0! It's actually 3.0, isn't it? Yeah. Both Black and Fire Red were all male. Actually, no. Black had Goma at the end. And Dragon. It was all male for most of it, I remember. And Fire Red was undoubtedly Sausage Fest, but those two were both ages ago. So I really shouldn't even count them. Cutie Fly would have also been a great Pokemon I would love to use in a Nuzlocke. Like, I would love to use a Cutie Fly in a Nuzlocke, but that probably won't happen. Be right back to heal again, because I don't want to use an item to heal the paralysis. Alright, we're back. We're walking this way. There's a preschool that we can murder, but no, I don't feel like murdering him right now. I'm gonna talk to you. But the cemetery, yeah, the cemetery. Here's another area. Another new Pokemon! Let's not start with Rapier. Let's start with Shamshir. I feel like Shamshir has a good chance of having something not very effective against the foe. Or I could just use something that I know is decently weak. In theory. Alright, so what do we get here? It is Murkrow. Huh. Technically, I used a Murkrow in my Emerald Randomizer, which was on live streams. Vice Grip shouldn't kill it, right? He was named Nevermore. He was actually a great team member who actually survived the Elite Four and used them in the Elite Four. So he was a final team member. Since it was a Murkrow, and it was in a Gen 3 game, so I couldn't evolve him. Since now, this could become a Honchkrow someday, I will gladly catch this and use this Murkrow on my team. Gladly use this Murkrow, if I happen to catch it, which I did not. So, I'm actually going to switch now to be someone else, so I don't die. Actually, Bite will do less. Let's do Bite. Let's do Bite now to do a little more HP to it. There we go. And now I really have to switch. Really, really, really have to switch. Okay, let us go to Shank. Because you will take attacks really well. Because your defense is effectively doubled with your ability, so. And that doesn't even hurt me. He doesn't get astonished. Let's use a Premier Ball, because why not? They're completely worthless. You might as well throw them. Completely worthless ball. No, Premier Balls never work. Never. Premier Balls never, ever work. At least not in my experience. Those were a regular Pokeball. I also bought more Pokeballs. Just Pokeball. I didn't buy Great Balls. Great Balls were given to me. I can't buy Great Balls yet. They weren't available at the shop. And apparently Murkrow has a very low catch rate. I thought it. That's why I threw a Great Ball at first. But, it's lower on HP, so maybe it'll work now? Maybe? Status problems would be great right now. Okay. Alright, I'm gonna cut to when something important happens. Okay, finally. Finally got in a great ball. Okay, I wasted a ton of balls on this thing, but whatever, we got it. We got it, guys, no worries. We got the freaking Murkrow. This better have been worth all those balls I just threw. I wonder where I get a Duskstone. Might not be for quite a while, unfortunately. But otherwise, if I can get a Vileite, that would also be good, too. So, all right, nickname for Murkrow. Let's see. Okay, guys, I'm sorry. I don't mean to brag, but this is the most amazing nickname I could have think of. Bayonet. Why bayonet? Well, first of all, a bayonet, I believe, is a blade at the end of someone's gun. That's what usually a bayonet is. Why is bayonet such an amazing nickname? Because it sounds like Bayonetta. You know, that character from the game Bayonetta, who is a witch. Murkrow is based on a witch and a crow. Boom. Perfect nickname. So, there you go. I'm gonna go heal. I'll be right back. Now, I haven't looked at the two new Pokemon I caught. Rapier is, sassy nature. I'm gonna say that's not very good. What about Bayonet? Something neutral nature looks like. I didn't mean to leave. Yes, bashful. Okay, good. Peck Astonish Pursuit. Pursuit is the strongest move right now, which that's actually kind of sad. That Pursuit is your best move right now. That's all right. I don't want to start with Shamshire, or do I? No, I definitely don't. I just want to make sure I'm gonna fight a trainer, not walk through grass. If I'm walking through grass, then yes, I want to start with someone good. There's a trainer over there. So yes, I will put Rapier up front. Is there anybody over here? There's grass over there. Oh, there's that item over there. I'll get that eventually. Hello. When I come to Pokemon Cemetery, it's no good because I get so mournful. Well, then why do you go? Isn't that why you go? So you can mourn? Like, that's the reason? Never mind. Alright, Pikipek! Pikipek? Go Rapier! Alright, level 9. So yeah, we're so over-leveled. Sorry, I didn't mean to. If I did not train, I would be like level definitely 12 or 13 still. Guaranteed. I mean, at least Cutlass, and Shamshire would, but, the others probably not. Especially not, Shank, but that's fine. Goodbye, critical hit, oh, darn, I was gonna say, wow, this game, you crushed it, but a critical hit, that's fine. Hey, whatever works, dude, if you wanna get a critical hit, no, that great, awesome. Hey everyone, sorry for the abrupt cut right there, and it being a suddenly different time of day, but I was interrupted during my recording and I had to stop suddenly, so it's now the next day, so that's why that happened, and I had to just run back to heal, I think, and I also grabbed an item right there, is all I did off screen. And then we're gonna go this way, I believe. April, let's not have him up front, let's have Cutlass up front, just in case I run into something and can't run away. Because that has definitely happened to me. A couple times. Here's a person fight. If I'm gonna fight someone, I should have my weak person up front. I didn't think that part through. Well, that's what I get. Oh well. Ikui. Oh, does she have Pikachu? Yep. Fun fact, this lady, she is named after the voice actress of Pikachu. That's her real name. Ikui something. I don't actually know what it is, but that I learned that. From something. So that makes me smart, okay? I'm smart, guys. Trust me. Also, something I was thinking about between the two recording sessions of this one episode, this single episode, I was thinking of why I'm getting disappointed in the fact that this is mostly the same game. Because, you know, what was I supposed to be expecting, you know? I was hoping for a Black and White 2, like I said. Because Black and White 2 are very different games from the first Black and White. Very, very different games. Yeah, they're the same region, and six of the gym leaders are the same, or is it less? No, it's less than that. Yeah, less, I think four or five of the gym leaders are the same. Oh, hold on, I'm wearing Tail Whip? I have a higher chance of using that than, well, wait, what's the point of having Tackle if I have Headbutt? I don't need Tackle anymore. I don't think I'll use Telepath. I would more so want to lower the enemy's attack power as opposed to lower the defense. Let me go back and heal that paralysis, I'll be right back! Okay, I'm back. As I'm saying, yes, the main reason... Are you a trainer? You don't appear to be. You're afraid to rest. I am addressing it using its words. Okay. This is confide! I'll never use that, thanks. So, I did say earlier that the main reason I was hoping for Black and White 2 is because I didn't just want a better version of Sun and Moon, because I didn't think those games needed to be outdated yet, or outclassed by a game that's the same thing but better, you know? While that is still true, there's another big reason that I realized. I feel like I'm ripping you guys off. Can I please run away from this gaslight? Please? Please? That's gonna paralyze me, isn't it? No. Please. Please. So much for switching someone else out, whatever. I feel like I'm ripping you guys off. Because I already did a Sun Nuzlocke. A full playthrough of Sun, and in a Nuzlocke form. If this game is hardly any different from Sun and Moon, then I feel like I'm just doing a repeat playthrough for you guys. And it's like, why should we watch this? This is the same thing. So that's why I'm a little disappointed that I maybe this is telling me that I shouldn't do playthroughs blindly anymore. Because I don't know how different they're gonna be. Maybe when it's a brand new generation like it was for Sun, then that's fine. But like third versions or whatever you want to call Ultra Sun or Ultra Moon are to these games. Maybe I should play them on my own first, or do like a live stream regular playthrough, and then decide if I want to do a Nuzlocke of them. I don't know, just some things to consider. Oh, you could probably take care of a Happini, right? Except you missed, because you have Hustle. We can do that again. We can try again. Don't worry, we can have a couple tries. No, you missed again. Okay, no worries. Yeah, it's fine. It's your first battle, you're probably a little nervous. You're probably a little nervous that you're screwing up, but you are screwing up. Stop screwing up, thanks. That did that much. Okay, cool. See, that's a random thought. I just hope you guys are enjoying this, because I'm definitely having fun with the game. There's no question of that. There's no question I'm having fun with this playthrough, and that I'm looking forward to another challenge of Sun and Moon, because I've wanted to play through again. I just never could, because I always got bored. And I'm seeing why, because it's the beginning of these games are very, very long and drawn out. So, yeah. That's all. I hope you guys are enjoying this. Otherwise, I feel like I'm ripping you guys off, because this is almost the same game as I've already done. Not even that long ago. Like, for example, I have done repeat playthroughs before. Like, I did Platinum Wedlock. I've done Platinum before, but that was ages ago when I last did Platinum. So I felt like that was at least a little justified. Same with doing Alpha Sapphire after doing regular Sapphire. Or Sapphire after doing Ruby question mark. They were different enough to justify it. And same with when I did White, so long after Black, my very first Nuzlocke ever. You get the idea. There were justifications for those, and I cannot hurt Drifloom. I don't have any dark moves yet. Bayonet, you have a dark move, we can go to you. We're actually using our weak people. Good, I'm glad. Yeah. You get the idea. So I just hope you guys are enjoying this so far. And I hope you think that this is worth your time watching. To me, it's at least worth my time playing. Because I want to play this game. That's what I want. I want to play this game regardless. I like Pokemon games. I enjoy playing them. So, by that logic, I want to play the new game. That would be this. So that's what I'm doing. I just hope it justifies making a playthrough of it. So, that's all. And aftermath, I had a feeling it had aftermath, but I had enough HP left where it wasn't gonna, where I knew it wasn't gonna bother me. Yeah, I'm gonna pop this kid's balloon. And then, I'm gonna run some errands. Alright, I'll go heal, be right back. Alright, we back! Is there anything over here? No. No. Oh, here's a sticker! Gotcha. 7 stickers. Is that... I swear this is a little different. Either that or I'm having really bad memory. What is this house? Maybe this was here before. It's just... I don't know. I just don't think this was all that important. But there's a book slanted. That means you could obviously read it. And it's just a photo album. That's lame. Wasn't here. Oh, some all-star athlete character? I was gonna say maybe this was Ilima's house, but no, he lived back in Hauli. Remember that? Yeah. Because he's friends with without a word of your parents. Huh. I guess I don't know who this is the parent of. Those golf clubs there, I'm wondering if it's Kahili? The Elite Four member? That's my only thought. But Kahili looked decently older. So we're up in the sea, that's right, welcome to the wonderful Seaside Motel. My criminal shows it something, isn't he? He nabs passerby to bring them to me, so I can send them down to the bay. He's been a little too good at this job, so I've got no vacant rooms to offer you. That means we've come for nothing. So you're saying you use your crawler to force people to rent your motel rooms? Buy my motel, rent my room, or crawler, I'll punch you in the face. Wow. Hey, it's a good business strategy. I just don't think it's legal. I feel like one of you gives me something. I feel like you give me a TM of some kind. Or a Pokeballs. Yeah, Pokeballs. You give me 2 nest balls. Thank you. Appreciate that. Yes, now I can catch weak Pokemon, which is good for early in the game. Because everything's weak. But later on, then, eh. They're not really important. Is the vending machine still sold out of drinks at the beginning of the game? Yep. Yep. Wow, great. Okay. Well, this little area is different with that guy with the Crabrawler. And this new area over here. So, let's see. Oh! He's a trainer, and he's a surfer dude. Oh yeah, something else I know about these games. There's apparently something called Mantine Surfing, which seems to be like a mini game where you surf on a Mantine and do tricks and stuff. That's all I know about it. I don't know any details but that. So, I think that's what this is. Oh boy, Surfer Carlton. Alright, yeah, he looks like a surfer. Delibird. Why would a surfer have Delibird? Like, that's the last Pokemon I would picture a surfer to have. But okay. Raper, you probably would be okay, but... just in case. Let's go to Cutlass. Just in case. Yeah, Cutlass, Shamshir, and Shank are definitely overleveled, but... I don't care. They have to be. They don't have to be, but I was worried about dying. So, there's no good balance, is there? Like, I didn't know how else I could have beaten that Rowlet that the teacher had, unless I was a little higher level than it. And it just healed me. Thanks. Thanks, Delibird, thanks. And I would have been just fine as Rapier. Unless he missed 2 times in a row, like he did before. Which is probably going to be a recurring thing with him, to be quite honest. Because that's the Rattata's ability. Hustle. So... Yay, level 10 for Rapier. Wants to learn Bite. Yay, good, a dark move. Let's get rid of Tackle, because it has the same base power as Quick Attack. It just doesn't always go first. So, good job. We got Bite. Something about I wasn't even feeling it, so you're not Shulk. Okay, that's fine. I didn't expect you to be Shulk, because you... I mean, you do have a shirtless outfit like he does, but you're not exactly the right skin color. So, no, I didn't think you were Shulk, so you didn't have to tell me you weren't feeling it. I could have figured that out. Okay, so this probably looks like what that is. Because what else would this be? Big Wave Beach. Hey, new area! Is there even grass over here? Or is there even Pokemon you can find in the water? Probably not. Welcome to our BP shop. You can choose beach points, or was it battle points? What did BP stand for? That's actually kind of funny. Alright, I actually should end this episode here because I forgot that I already recorded a lot and then I had to take a break. So, I'll explore this area a little bit more in the next episode. And then, yeah, we'll do other stuff. Thank you for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. I'll see you next time. Rock on.